TGIF.
We're down to only three more of those statements before the end of the year.
Hang on for some tips and how to survive the next 18 and wait and a wake up.
Through the window, by the window, that is where I'll become tiptoe through the tulips with me.
It's Friday, May 1st, 2015. I'm Jessica Pena.
And I'm Gage Schiff with the administrative reminders.
And for tip number one, we have today's Mars behavior.
And that would be safety.
We understand that everyone is getting excited about the end of the school year.
But be sure that you don't get too excited and start making dangerous decisions.
For example, look both ways before crossing the street.
Quit running through the hallways.
And watch it with the horseplay.
If you can manage that, you'll likely end the school year unscathed.
And for tip number two, avoid Saturday school.
And you can do that simply keep your grades up.
Tip number three, avoid after-school detention by getting to class on time without running.
Tip four, avoid making a major fashion mistake by wearing the proper uniforms so that you don't have to wear those disgusting poo brown shirts.
We can wear navy blue, black, white, and khaki colors for pants, skirts, and polo-style shirts.
And besides that, you can wear proper color zip-up hoodies, no leggings or jeans, and no logos.
If you wear something that is out of uniform, put it in your locker.
If you are always cold, then wear things that are in uniform.
Tip five, the office is not handing out ice packs and Band-Aids.
Tip six, teachers know that the earbuds dangling from your ears are attached to your phones.
If you want to keep your phones, earbuds, and headphones, then put them in your lockers.
Tip seven, leave the food, gum, and candy at home. It's a district rule that says the stuff isn't allowed.
And tip number eight, put the trash in the trash cans. It's actually illegal to throw trash on the ground anyway.
And that's our last tip for the day.
Stay tuned in for regular announcements.
Hey, I don't mean to disturb you, but can you help me on simplifying?
Sure. So, what you're going to do here is you're trying to make the problem smaller.
Smaller?
Yeah, smaller. You're dividing it into its smallest point.
So I have 64 out of 96, but I don't know how to divide that well, so dividing this into smaller would be a little difficult for me. I just don't get it.
Calm down, I have an idea. Hey, Ron, get over here.
Hey, what's up?
All right, Kajana, I need you to stand right here. We're gonna teach William how to simplify. All right, so imagine he represents 64.96. We're gonna reduce him. Go ahead and rip his arm off.
Wait, no!
But we can simplify him even further. Now we can reduce him to 16.24, so if you just take a leg. And now we can reduce them to 8/12, and 4/6, and finally to 2/3. And that is how you simplify a fraction.
So he's just ahead.
I don't like you. I hate you, man. Get away from me.
We've got your announcements. I'm Christian Ontiveros.
And I'm Leticia Hernandez, kicking things off with another bizarre holiday.
And it can get any stranger than National School Principals Day.
Today is a day of reconciliation for elementary, middle, and high school principals for their leadership and dedication of providing the best education possible for their students.
And the reason that it's held on May 1st is because that's about the time they all get running through the hall screaming, Mayday, Mayday.
So be sure to show Mr. Nason, Dr. Clayton, and Mr. Everett some love today.
We love you guys. Now, on to the regular announcements.
Don't forget that there is only nine days of school left in the Reading Buddy and Dinner program.
That's still going on Monday through Thursdays right here.
And so far as we know, $11 can still get you a Pizza Paul's card, good for an old Chicago pizza worth up to $25.
Bring cash or checks made out to JSAA to room 153, and our students will give you the goods.
And this Monday night, be sure to participate in Helping Hands fundraiser at Hut from 6 to 8:30. See Mrs. Jennifer Smith next to the library for all the info.
Don't forget that only have one more opportunity for free dress.
You can still get the 2-for-5 deal for May 7th and 8th.
Miss Smith will be selling the passes at and in the mornings.
Be sure to get them because if not, the day of free dress will set you back $6.
I hear a dance party coming soon.
So if you would like to party it up one last time, be sure to purchase your tickets for $3.
And if I... All you readers out there, all library books checked out by any staff or student are due by Friday, May 22nd.
The last day for a checkout will be Monday, May 18th, unless specially required by teachers for a quick read.
That's all we have today for the daily announcements. Stay tuned for clubs and events.
I'm Lizbeth Diaz with Clubs and Events.
And I am Eduardo Trujillo.
Before we actually get going, we have some history for you.
On May 1st, 1931, the Empire State Building in New York has dedicated and opened.
It was 102 stories tall and was the tallest building in the world at the time.
Interestingly, the current tallest building is Burj Khalifa in Dubai, which is 163 floors. On Tuesday, pre-engineering goes on with Mr. Anderson in room 121.
And the Native American Club meets in Ms. Behan's room and is sponsored by Mr. Cordova on the same day.
On Wednesdays, Video Lab is working on some fun commercials in the studio with Miss Duffy.
Or you can go to Girl Power with Miss Nelson Wednesdays as well.
And on Thursdays, the orchestra students will be meeting with Miss Bowen in room 512.
Finally, National Junior Honor Society has two more meetings in room 144 today and then the 15th.
Our clubs run from 4:10 to 5:30.
And at 5:30, have the option of having dinner at school.
You can catch the activity bus.
Be sure that you are off completely off campus by 5:55, and don't forget that this all ends the week of May 14th.
Finally, we would like to let you know about two upcoming events.
First up, the Spring Band Concert is going on the May the 7th at 6:30.
Come and listen to our delicate tones of our growing band program.
Then on the 12th at 6:30, our award-winning orchestra takes the stage.
Be sure to check them out. That's all. I'm Eduardo Trujillo.
And I'm Elizabeth Diaz.
Have a great day and stay tuned for sports.
Meet Eddie. He is popular, confident, and, at least in his own mind, good-looking. But even Eddie has odor problems every now and then. When smelly, Eddie grabs his oversized bottle of Axe spray for men. Run, Eddie, run. I hear the cops.
Sports is next.
Swigert Sports is winding down. I'm Cami Azra.
And I'm Bailey Keel.
The next volleyball match is on May 5th, which is next Tuesday.
That's a 4:30 away game at North.
Also, next week, we have the famous beating day in the small gym next Tuesday.
If you don't sign up ahead of time, you do not get in.
And on Wednesday, we have soccer in the gym.
Thursday is a special treat with horseshoes.
Followed by battle ball on Friday.
All events run from 7:15 to 7:50, and you must remember to be on time and remain on your best behavior.
In national sports, the NBA continues Game 7 with the Nets versus the Hawks and the Grizzlies versus the Warriors.
Don't miss the Bulls go against the Bucks at 5 and the Clippers versus the Spurs at 7:30.
In the world sports, we got to see International Sport Day, a UN mandated International Day of Sports for Peace and Development, being celebrated in Ethiopia for the second time.
That's it for this week's sports. Before we go, here's a strange fact for you.
The sentence, "The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog," uses every letter of the alphabet.
And on that note, would everybody please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.